Hello and welcome to Excel if function. My name's Jeff, I'm glad you're here. Let's just jump right in. Now the if function allows us to do different kinds of math or return different kinds of results based on specific conditions. So I think the fastest way to get started is just to flip over to Excel. Okay, let's say I'm trying to compute a bonus amount. And if the employee is eligible, so if this column is equal to Y, their bonus is 500. Otherwise, if they're not eligible, so if this is equal to N, then their bonus is zero. So one way to accomplish this is by using an if function. Equals if. All right, there are three arguments. The test, the value if that test is true, and the value if that test is false. So what is our test? Our test is, does this equal yes? If our test is equal to yes, then what do we want the function to return? We want it to return the bonus amount of 500. Comma, and what if that test is false? What if it fails? What if it's not equal to y? Then we want to return zero. Close function and enter. Let's go ahead and fill this down and see if it worked. All right, so this is no, which is zero, which is what we wanted. These are both yes, this is 500, and zero, yes, 500. Okay, so this is working as expected. And that's the basic warm-up example. Let's go to the next example, exercise two. All right, here we want to do something more advanced. We want to look at multiple conditions, and there are several ways to handle multiple conditions, and we're going to demonstrate a few of those ways here. And this first option is by nesting multiple if functions together. So let's talk through the logic before we write the formula. Basically, if they are not eligible, it's zero. But if they are eligible, then we want to go to the next test, which is if they're vested. If vested is equal to no, then there's zero. Otherwise, if vested is equal to yes, then it's 500. So you can see there's multiple conditions. So one way to accomplish this is with multiple nested if functions. Here's what that looks like. Equals if. Okay, so the first thing is, if this is equal to no, then we know they do not get the bonus. So we know that the bonus is zero, comma. Otherwise, if that is false, we're gonna have another if function in there. And then we wanna say, is vested equal to no. So if that is no, then we know it's zero, comma. If it's not no, then we know it's yes. And this works because there's only two options here. So we'd want to return 500. We close that if function, we close the outer if function, enter. And now we can fill this down and let's just double check. So this is a no and a yes, so it should be zero. This is a yes and a no, so it should be zero. These are all yeses, so that looks good. This looks good, and then this looks good. But nesting multiple if functions together is only one way to accommodate multiple conditions. So let's go to the next exercise, exercise three. Here we're going to use some helper functions, and or. So let's check this out. Same basic logic, equals if. Now what I want to say is, for the logical test, don't just look at one column, look at two columns, or look at multiple columns. And we can use the or function or the and function to look at one or more conditions. And the way that the or function works is this. If any one of the conditions are true, then or returns true. And works like this. If all of the conditions are true, then and returns true. So let's check it out. If or. Okay, and what I want to say is, if this is equal to n, or if this is equal to n, comma. Now I'm back in the if function. If either of those are equal to n, then I know they get zero. Otherwise, they get 500. Close the function and enter, and let's fill this down and just double check that it worked. So this should have been zero, which it is. This is zero, these are all 500, zero, 500. So that works, okay? So that's one way to do it. But depending on what you're working on and depending what makes the most sense, we could also use and. So equals if, and. Now, if this is equal to yes, and if this is equal to yes, then they get the bonus. Otherwise, they get zero. Close function and enter. And now I can fill this down, and if it worked, we should get the same results, which we do. So that's another way to handle multiple conditions, by using the and function, which returns true when all of its arguments are true, or by using the or function, which returns true if any one of the arguments are true. But there's another way, so let's go to the next exercise. Exercise four. Okay, here we're gonna use the ifs function. Now the ifs function is designed to look at a string of conditions, and whichever one hits true first is the one that's returned. So here's how we set it up, equals ifs. All right, the first thing I wanna look at is this. If this is equal to no, if that's equal to no, then we return zero. If that's not true, Then it's going to look at the next argument. Okay, so the next one is this equal to no? And if that's equal to no, then we're going to return zero, comma. So it's just going in order. Once one of the logical tests returns true, it stops and ignores the remaining tests. So what if we wanted to say, otherwise, if none of those are true, then return 500? Well, the way that we could do that is just by saying true and then 500, because we know that true will return true. So that's a way to basically say, if this is not true, and if this is not true, then otherwise return this. So we hit enter, and let's go ahead and fill this down. So that's yet another option. That's how the Excel if function works. Those are how the arguments work. And these are a couple of different ways that we can handle multiple conditions. Hopefully this helps. Thanks so much for joining me. Have a great day. Hey, Excel user, if you ever need to create summary reports, check out my Pivot Table for Beginners video. It starts at the beginning and shows how to store the data transactions in a table and then how to summarize those transactions with a Pivot Table report. I hope it helps unlock the incredible power of Pivot Tables.
This video is a production of Excel University.